Certainly it's not a stretch. But I love candy. But I had to quit trick-or-treating last year. Mostly because my Silver Surfer outfit was freaking people out. Nobody wants to see a nearly 40-year-old dude in a silver bikini bottom holding an ironing board and a Glad bag. How you doing? Trick or treat! But the good news is that now I get to man the door at my house. See, and here's the thing. I've been out there, and I know what the kids need, right? So, and y'all make me mad because, all right, you come to my house, I go full size, not fun size. Full size, not fun. What's fun about this? Fucking nothing, actually. Truth be told, you know what's fun? Candy bar you can lay down on. Yeah, that's fun. I rock full size, if you will, and I have all the candy food groups represented. And when I say that, I mean, you know, I have a chocolate caramel situation for you, if you will. Chocolate peanut butter, chocolate with nougat, chocolate with nuts. Not a lot of nuts. Not, I'm not going to unload an Almond Joy on you and expect you to dig that, man. That is too much nuts, Johnny Protein. Go lift weights elsewhere, all right? That's not what we're about tonight. Maybe we do a Snickers or a Mr. Goodbar. That's good proportions right there. Some, if not all, of the M&M family at my party. What if I'm diabetic? Well, I have sugar-free and white chocolate for you. What if I don't like chocolate at all? Well, don't sweat that, my friend, because I have you covered in what I like to refer to the pectin-based fruit chews. I.e. Skittles, Dots, Jujubes, Mexican hats if I can find them. Razzles, Razzles, half candy, half gum. What is it? Who gives a shit? Don't overthink it. Let the razzle become you. Eat it, chew it, spit it out, put it in your sister's hair. Don't worry about it. It's Halloween, man. Don't overthink this. Don't get hung up. I just have two rules. I have two rules when you come to my house on Halloween. They're pretty simple, man. Wear a costume. Wear a costume, because if you've manned your door at your own house, you know how many kids will roll up 14 years old with no costume and an attitude. You know, and you know what I say to those dudes? A dude comes up on my porch like that. I'm like, hey, is this no costume candy giveaway day? I didn't think so. Get off my porch. Before I thump you, get off. I'm serious. Get off the porch. Come back on no costume candy giveaway day, and we'll do some business then, certainly. But at now, then get off. Wear a costume. And my other rule, don't grab. Don't grab and run. Don't be Johnny reach and grab. Don't be yanking and pull. Let me assess you. And then design a candy situation for you. I think you'd be pleased. Candy is my medium, so let me go to work. You'll be happy. So Spider-Man number 4 comes down my driveway in a series of Spider-Mans. And it's not looking good for this kid from the get-go, man. He's got his mask off. His suit's kind of baggy. He's crying. He's about 13. He's with his little sister. She's got the Little Mermaid costume, and she's fantastic, man. Her costume is rocking. She is kicking ass. She has actual red hair. She is blowing my mind, and she's not going to be able to leave my porch unassisted. That's how much candy she's going to get, all right? And I am in love, and I am going to load her down with all kinds of goodness. And they're with their mom, and the mom explains to me that the reason that dude is crying is because his sister keeps ringing the doorbell, and he wants to. Now, if you know anything about me or who I am as a person or what I try and say when I'm on stage, you know that I'm a dude that says, hey, you're a young man and you got some tears, you go ahead and cry them. Go ahead and cry your tears. Don't bottle that shit up and then bring it into your relationships later on in life, make it everybody else's problem, all right? You go ahead and cry your tears. However, pick your battles, bro. Pick your battles. All right, 13 crying at doorbells, long, hard road for you, I fear. Long, hard road, all right? We need to kind of... This is not worthy of tears, man. So I'm not going to punish the kid at all, you know what I mean? But he's not going to go chocolate caramel. We'll probably do something in a razzle, you know, Mexican hat thing. And as I am unloading candy on his sweet sister, dude, there's a sign that says, do not grab. Dude reaches, yanks bag out of my hand. Whoa. And I can hear under his breath, he yells, gimme, gimme. And I snapped. And I said, whoa, hang on there, Crybaby Spiderman. I don't know that I'm familiar with Crybaby Spiderman. I don't remember reading any of his comic books. What are his special powers? Getting me caught in a web of tears because daddy ain't buying. I realized I had two options at that point. Now, I have another bag called the punishment bag, and that is a bag that is filled with broccoli and kale and warm asparagus, artichoke hearts, feta cheese. I could do that, or I could be a super bro, slip back on the Silver Surfer costume, take the dude out, and show him how to get this thing right. Because let me tell you something, it's a simple, honest, happy, great holiday, man. It's simple, it's like a job, man. You show up, you get dressed, and you get paid in candy! And you meet other people, you're networking, you're in the neighborhood, it's a beautiful holiday. Do not fuck this up and do not cry during it. So I asked his mom if this is all right. I slipped back on the Silver Surfer costume, man. It's a year later than I should have been wearing it, man. I ain't got abs for that, but I did it. And I took dude for a walk. We did a couple blocks together and it was fine until the motherfucker kept ringing the doorbell. I like to ring the doorbell. I like to be the surprise.